Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Sunday or Monday, depending on your time zone, there was the launch of a new shell of Constellation satellites with the Starlink 3-1 mission.
Zero, ignition. And liftoff of the Falcon 9 and Starlink.
Pitching downrange.
Stage 1, chamber pressure is nominal.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1063, then landed successfully for the third time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1, landing confirmed.
Alright, as you saw there briefly, as the smoke clears, there we see once again, Falcon 9 has landed, marking SpaceX's 55th first stage landing on our drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
We also have some more Falcon 9 launches expected this week. As you can see on the SpaceXFans website, the launch of CRS25 is scheduled to lift off on Friday 15th at 12:44 a.m. UTC or Thursday 14th at 8:44 p.m. EDT. In addition, we may also be able to expect the Starlink 422 mission on Sunday 17th, but there's no time specified currently. There was a tweet posted with a screenshot from Everyday Astronaut's most recent Starbase tour video. It says, so, for the super observant of you, you will have noticed something big in the new EDA Starbase Tour Part 4 video, and that big thing is Starlink V2 satellite sitting inside Tent 1. In reference to the Starlink launch that happened on Monday, Musk posted a tweet. He said these polar launches will enable complete coverage of Earth where approval by local government. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch site. Crews were seen removing an actuator from the chopstick catching arms. Crews were seen working at the top of the launch tower as well. SpaceX's crane was seen being moved at the launch site. This new chopstick actuator was seen delivered to the production yard. The Star Factory production building continues to progress. The nose cone test structure was moved away from Starbase. This ship common dome was placed on the sleeving mount. Ship 24 continues to be worked on a top suborbital pad B. Work continued on Booster 7 prior to some planned testing on Monday. Monday was very interesting because during Booster 7 testing there was an explosion. When this very unexpected event happened, Chris Burgin posted a tweet about it. After that, somebody captioned a screenshot and tweeted at Elon Musk asking if it was intentional. He responded and confusingly answered with yes, however a short while later he deleted the tweet. In response to Chris Burgin's tweet we just saw, Musk posted a tweet confirming the actual reality of what had happened. He said, yeah, actually not good. Team is assessing damage. In response to that tweet, Jonathan McDowell posted in the big picture, still early days with Raptor 2. Still learning, I guess. Good luck with the analysis. Musk responded to this with, cryogenic fuel is an added challenge as it evaporates to create fuel air explosion risk in partially oxygen atmosphere like Earth. That said, we have a lot of sensors to detect this. More later. Then, in response to that, Musk was asked, Elon, would it be possible to maybe burn or evaporate the leaks caused before ignition? I guess Space Shuttle used to do this. They used to set up small sparks under the shuttle's engine section and burn off all the hydrogen leaks that may have happened before ignition. He responded and said, this is one of the things we will be doing going forward. This particular issue, however, was specific to the engine spin start test. Raptor has a complex start sequence. Going forward, we won't do a spin start test with all 33 engines at once. Everyday Astronaut posted a tweet saying, very curious how this plays out for B7. The biggest question is how are the engines? What kind of damage was done to them? I'm teetering between it being catastrophic to the engines and tis but a scratch. Can't wait to hear what the teams determine and what the next steps are. Musk responded to that with, base of the vehicle seems okay by flashlight. I was out there just about an hour ago. We shut down the pad for the night for safety. We will know more in the morning. Scott Manley posted a tweet about this. He said, so I did a bit of rough math on this event based on the fact that it was a 1 atmosphere fuel air detonation over a volume and there are limits on air methane mixture for detonation, the energy released was likely close to a couple of kilos of TNT. After the explosion there were 2 fires that started and went out at the launch site. So, contrary to what one would expect given what happened on Monday, there are still possible closures scheduled. As you can see, the dates are similar to last video with a possible closure tomorrow, Thursday 14th. Plus, they also have that possible closure for next week with Monday 18th. However, with the unexpected explosion that happened, I would say there's almost certainly no chance for some testing. Yesterday, Musk posted a tweet with a video of the Starbase launch tower as crews examine how much damage was done by the explosion. He responded to that and said was just up in the booster propulsion section. Damage appears to be minor, but we need to inspect all the engines. Best to do this in the high bay. There was an article posted about this event and the FAA. It says the Federal Aviation Administration said Tuesday it was in close contact with SpaceX as the company reviewed a fire that occurred as part of its Super Heavy booster rocket development, but that the agency was barred from investigating the matter. Here's a look at the charred orbital launch mount legs. Musk was also asked on Twitter any updates on how long until orbital flight will happen. He responded and said, if testing goes well, as soon as next month. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, and Nikansuini for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.